In the previous episode,
with the on launch of the new virtual banks, there will certainly be heightened competition.
So, the million-dollar question is, how will virtual banks impact the Hong Kong banking landscape in the future?
Bill Gates once said that banking is necessary, but banks is not. As we speak to banking executives, and some of the most forward-thinking ones, and we ask them, who are your competitors? They will not say the other banks. In fact, what they say and what they have said for the past few years is that their competitors are going to be the internet companies. And going back to Bill Gates' quote, what is a bank today may not be what it is going forward.
FinTech is going to enable a lot of different parties. We are enabling them to step into the area which in the past they have never been able to step into.
Previously, when customers had financial needs, they would go to a bank. Nowadays, what banks want to do, or what even fintechs want to do, is to be able to offer financial services at the point where customers need them, whatever that is.
When we look at virtual bank or we look at fintech, it will never be like a disruptor. We always look at it as an enabler. So we enable them to do more in terms of the financial and trying to make the ecosystem to be even more competitive.
The introduction of virtual banks in the market will help to spur innovation in the banking sector, as the incumbent banks would have to modernize their infrastructure, digitize some of their processes, and create better products in order to maintain their competitiveness.
The traditional banks are also transforming themselves to ensure that the customer experience can be much more convenient beyond the brick and mortar and the 9-to-5 traditional mode. For example, as our bank's example, today if you open an account, this can already be done totally remotely.
So what will happen?
In the first 2 to 3 years, definitely there will be competition. But virtual bank won't be like taking a big share of the asset and things. It's more like there will be very specific services that virtual banks may be a clear win. 4 or 5 years, maybe, they will be going into more like different kinds of services because those customer space that they already grab, then they have other needs and they gradually grow from there. I would say that they will still eye on the scalability of the business. If those services that they provide cannot be scalable, will only be still be very expensive to serve the customers, I don't think virtual banks will be like very interested.
I think the pie of the consumer banking sector really hinges on the growth of the Hong Kong economy and the hope that it will open up to the Greater Bay Area and China as a big market where there are a lot of interest in the banking services offered in Hong Kong and the wide range of product capabilities, notably in the wealth management arena in Hong Kong.
Hong Kong is famous for being an international financial center, right? So that will help to create the credibility for the bank in Hong Kong to go beyond Hong Kong and expand into GBA or a different part of the world, right?
How we have a better integration in the Greater Bay Area with cross-border. There are a lot of collaboration cross-border with different regulators, different authorities, something like more or less sandbox, like cross-border for the Greater Bay Area, so that the banks or the fintech companies can jump into the sandbox and play around and try to test out new products and do the experiments in a more controlled environment.
It's about how open government and regulator can propel the virtual banks keep introducing innovation. The regulation regime can be flexibly adjusted to the request from virtual banks to introduce more new innovation. I think that's key.
We hear in the news that there are cross-border wealth management new regulation that will loosen up. Also, the relaxation of the foreign exchange control between China and Hong Kong, that will enable the money flow via digital means without the Hong Kong banks having to invest in the brick and mortar in China. So this whole growth of the middle class in wealth management needs and the cross-border accessibility of products on both sides will be a big impetus for growth.
We believe that banking, and in some ways the real world, is going to become closer and closer and more interlinked and even merged together. And when the world gets to that point, what is a bank again may be completely redefined.
How digital will Hong Kong become in a few years' time? Can Hong Kong virtual and traditional banks successfully elbow their way into the multi-billion-dollar Greater Bay Area market?